William Shakespeare is one of the best known, most celebrated, most quoted writers in the history of our language, but not a lot is known about what he looked like. Well, today in London, a portrait was unveiled that scholars say is almost certainly him and probably the only accurate likeness ever painted during his lifetime. Recently discovered, hidden away and unidentified in a private collection, the painting is, for lovers of William Shakespeare, truly the stuff dreams are made.
A gentleman, richly attired in the height of Jacobean fashion, doublet and lace collar, long-nosed, fine-bearded, and to our surprise blessed with a foolish head of hair. There's intelligence here, a presence.
Is this William Shakespeare as we've never seen him before, a likeness painted during his own lifetime? The portrait is so good, you somehow imagine the man himself sitting for it.
This portrait, I think, is somebody that I can believe was a great creative artist. This is the man that lies behind The Tempest, King Lear, and Midsummer Night's Dream, for example. So that's why it's important to me.
So how sure are you?
99%.
We know so little about Shakespeare the man, what he was like as a friend, lover, husband. Our image of him comes from the engraving in the First Folio, published 7 years after his death. He fixes us with his eyes, the cranium is large, the hair receding. The young Flemish engraver, Martin Drushout, almost certainly copied the image from something else. Could it have been our portrait, or more likely, a copy of it? The basic physiognomy seems to fit, although the hair was yet to retreat.
One thing that really clinched it for me was when I saw the image, the superimposition of the Drushout engraving on the portrait, which is a perfect fit. I really thought that was sensational.
In Holy Trinity Church in Stratford-upon-Avon, where Shakespeare is buried, there's a painted bust in a niche, goose feather poised. Again, it's a posthumous interpretation. There's a blankness here. The poet dramatist is pork butcher. We've long needed something livelier. Alec Cobb is central to the discovery of this new portrait. His family trust owns it. He spent his childhood at Newbridge, a large house outside Dublin, crammed with pictures. He still remembers his nightly climb up to bed, past the ancestral portraits.
When you trudged up to bed, from the age of four, we were even allowed to hold our own paraffin lamps, because the house didn't have electricity in Ireland. And so you trudged upstairs to bed with your lamp in your hand and all these sort of layers of dark old portraits, men with beards, glaring and glowering. And you get to the top of the stairs when the layers had diminished to one picture just at the very top. And this was Lady Norton, and she was rather nice. And so I quite liked her.
Lady Norton turned out to have a secret. She wasn't a she, but a he. In 2002, an expert identified the portrait as the Earl of Southampton, an effeminate youth with a thick rope of hair that dangled to his waist. More importantly, he was the only known literary patron of William Shakespeare. In 2006, Alec Cobb and the same expert visited a special Shakespeare exhibition at the National Portrait Gallery in London. Here were six portraits, all at one time or another, contenders for being the man.
We both stopped dead in front of this picture that was one of the six at the end of the exhibition. Alistair said, "Don't you have one of these?" And I said, "Yes, we do, and rather better, actually."
Placed side by side, the similarity is obvious, but the painting from the Folger Shakespeare Library in Washington is evidently a copy, dead-eyed and lifeless. The Cobb portrait is plausibly the original.
Alec Cobb and his curator set about their Shakespearean research. It would take them 3 years. They were obviously aware of one copy of this image, the Folger version in Washington. They went on to find three others. This man was important. People wanted to own a copy of his image.
Here is one of the copies. And
Alec Cobb laid out the visual evidence before us, photos of his painting, what he believes are a series of 17th century copies. It's quite a lineup. On the left, the original Cobb portrait, joined by four copies, some completed within a few years of the original. At some point, the copyists decided to make him bald, to accord with the image on the Drusaut engraving. The Cobb portrait has been scientifically tested and dated to about 1610, when Shakespeare was 46. The painting has an inscription, Principum Amictias, Beware the Alliance of Princes. It's from the Roman poet Horace, and it was addressed by Horace to a playwright. This morning we crowded around the new discovery. Shakespearean scholars are famously quarrelsome, and there'll be a debate. A book is to be published, and the Cobb portrait and two copies will be exhibited from next month at the Shakespeare Birthplace Trust in Stratford-upon-Avon.
How do you expect things to play on from here?
Well, I should think an awful lot of people will say nonsense, it's not Shakespeare at all. It'll probably be the most likely scenario. But I won't necessarily believe them.
A photo from the early 1900s of the drawing room at the Cobb family seat in Ireland. The painting hung at head height. Someone had scribbled in ink on the back the name of Sir Walter Raleigh. It doesn't look remotely like him. No one thought until now that it might be someone rather more significant.